Guys, I am super stoked. We're here at our open house. Chris and Deborah are probably one of our older San Diego customers. They've got this awesome 5th Gen 4Runner. We set them up with some stuff probably, what, four and a half years ago, right? So it's super awesome to see them back. We didn't coordinate our dress outfits. I guess blue shorts and rhino shirts are the deal today. But hey, so super awesome to have you. I'm going to go through and ask Chris a couple things about his car. And he can tell us about it. And yeah, we just wanted to check it out. So, Chris, why don't we start with what you've done, kind of wheels, tires, suspension. Then we'll maybe go into some of the armor, and then we can get to what you're doing up top. Does that sound good?
Yeah, so like I said, 2016, 5th Gen 4Runner, obviously. Bought it stock years ago, and then started with a 3rd Gen, and then upgraded to this one. And then wanted to start building it out, and came across Yoast. And so slowly but surely, we've been piecing this thing together. This is almost version 2.0, because we started with a soft tent, got smart, and went off to the Camp King up top. Kind of starting down below, underneath, it's fully armored up with RCI armor, as well as the RCI rock sliders. And the tires, 285s, Needle Ridge Cracklers, the thick 6-ply sidewalls. And like I said, up front, Smittybilt, 10,000K winch, with the Southern Style Slime front bumper.
Yep.
Not much underneath the hood. Like I said, dual compressor ARB for the air.
Yeah, which is clutch.
Definitely.
The dual is key. It's the one thing on the Land Cruiser that I did the single, and I regret that. And it's been 10 years.
It's been
and I haven't upgraded it yet, so the dual is the way to go. Yeah.
Definitely. Awesome. There's a little bit of, like I said, a cut from underneath for the tires for some armor underneath there.
You did this then, right?
Yeah, absolutely.
Yep. Okay, yep. Cool.
Got that. And then kind of moving up to the plush camp hotel style.
Nice.
We started with Yoast here on the Pioneer, the roof rack as well. And then, like I said, 4.5 years ago, what is this, maybe the second or third Camp King
around?
Yeah,
it's got to be, I want to say, Chris, it's got to be, yeah, it may even be the second Camp King that we ever installed onto a vehicle. It may even be the second one after ours being the first one. So you may have been the first Camp King customer that we ever had here in the US. And it's really fun to see the tent back. I know you guys have been out using it, abusing it. I see it on Instagram all the time. If you guys don't follow Whiskey Wine Wondering, that's their handle. It's super awesome photography. So it's super rad to see the tent. So it's been holding up, it's working out for you
it's
guys?
It's been wonderful. Like I said, 4.5 years, we've gone everywhere from extreme heat, we've had it down into the gulches of Sedona where it was -4.
Oh, wow.
And the thing has been absolutely amazing.
Yeah.
Super easy. Like I said, we had this thing set up in about 1.5 minutes with the awning, and we're drinking beers by the fire. And it's been awesome. Like I said, we can keep so much of our gear. Not only is the bedding up there 24/7, but several camp chairs, some tables, and extra stuff for all of our bulldogs. Speaking of, the wife, myself, and 3 bulldogs guys are up inside this thing each night with no issues.
Nice.
I'm not the world's biggest man, but we sleep comfortably.
Still,
trust
that's
me.
Sweet.
Yeah. Absolutely amazing.
Yeah. I mean, it looks like. I mean, the fabrics is it looks like the day we put it on. We're out here in California sun. It's probably 100 degrees today alone. If you look at that fit and finish, it's really awesome to see. That it's just, you know, the unit that we run on our car is the same, but it's really awesome to see after this amount of time being out in the elements and the sun and just, you know, getting properly used, to see it, to, like, the quality is there, right? And that
absolutely,
I think that's the thing about these camping tents that are just so awesome. And not to mention, dude, this Rhino Rack platform, these things take a beating.
Absolutely.
And so it's just awesome. I mean, you guys load all sorts of stuff up there, which is great. So really, really awesome to see. Tell me a little bit about the back here.
Sure. Yeah, so the back is a Victory 4x4 with dual sling art bumper. Got some lighting in there with a drop down table. A couple little add ons for the ladder.
Yeah.
I don't have the high lift mount on it right now, but we own those as well from when we head out. But again, it's super easy, super clean. Had no issues with this.
Yeah.
Like I said, other than you add a little bit of weight, of course, to a 4Runner and the gas mileage goes down. But
yeah,
that's why we do it. Have fun.
Yeah, it's miles per mile, right?
Exactly.
Not miles per gallon. Well, awesome, man. I'm super stoked. I'm super stoked you came.
Absolutely.
You guys brought the dogs again and Deborah. And yeah, it's just this puts a big smile on my face to see this. So we'll let you get out of the heat here. But
yeah,
I appreciate it, man.
Absolutely.
Awesome. Thanks.